This fall, let's make healthy happen together. Now through September 25th, you can join Anytime Fitness for just $1. We're cleaning around the clock and offering in-gym and virtual training options. Here for you anytime, anywhere. Visit AnytimeFitness.com.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
A return to in-person learning with your Alexa Flash Briefing. I'm John Herrick. For Indianapolis Public Schools, pre-K through 3rd grade students can return to the classroom October 5th. Then pre-K through 6th grade can return to in-person classes October 19th, since the spread of coronavirus has decreased in Marion County.
Particularly for our youngest learners who are learning to read and identifying letters and those kinds of things, it's really important that they have, to the extent possible, the opportunity to safely learn in person with a teacher.
IPS Superintendent Alicia Johnson says 7th through 12th graders will be on a hybrid learning model that rotates based on students' last name. Face coverings will be required for all students coming back to in-person learning. Virtual learning is still an option for those who want to go that route. Washington Township Schools planning to bring students back for in-person learning as well. Developmental preschool and kindergarten through 2nd grade will return to full-time learning in the classroom beginning October 12th. 3rd through 5th graders come back for in-person learning October 19th. With middle and high school students able to come in for 2 days of in-school class and 3 days at home. Of course, learning from home is still an option. Restructuring the board that writes the rules for police is the goal of some Indianapolis City County councilors. Kurt Darling reports on why the president of the Indy Fraternal Order of Police says that's a bad idea.
Councilors want to put a civilian majority on the general orders board for IMPD. FOP President Rick Snyder says they've always desired civilian input, but says this course of action opens up the door for politics to invade fair and impartial policing.
We cannot have political agendas driving our policing practices and our policing decisions. That's a recipe for disaster.
He tells Hammer and Nigel on WIBC, putting a majority decision-making stake about what the department does in the hands of civilians undermines the authority of the chief of police. Kurt Darling, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Could Big Ten football teams actually play this fall? That includes Purdue and Indiana. The conference still has not made a decision, but they've had several meetings about it recently, despite saying they were pushing fall sports to the spring a couple months ago. University of Wisconsin Chancellor Rebecca Blank says the Big Ten usually announces things as a group. The country's largest mall owner says its malls will be closed on Thanksgiving this year. Rob Connett reports.
Simon Property Group says it's making the change so employees can spend time with their families on the holiday. The malls will then reopen for Black Friday shopping. Simon owns 10 malls throughout Indiana, including Circle Center Mall, Castleton Square, Hamilton Town Center, the Fashion Mall at Keystone, and the Greenwood Park Mall. Rob Connett, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The Frank Lloyd Wright-designed home in West Lafayette will be restored thanks to new funding. The National Park Service awarded $500,000 to the Samara restoration, and it was matched by private money from a memorial trust. The home became a National Historic Landmark, making it eligible for federal grants. Wright started working on the house in 1951. It's one of 7 Frank Lloyd Wright-designed properties in Indiana. WIBC's flash briefings are updated throughout the day, so you can always check for the latest local news. You can also rejoin us in the car at 93.1 FM to stay on top of the latest traffic alerts, weather, and news. I'm John Herrick, on the level, on the go, and on Twitter at 93WIBC and WIBC.com.